Hi there. Welcome to part two in our UV-Vis series. Today I'll discuss the importance of using an analytical balance to prepare your sample, and I'll walk you through the process.
Using Beer's law, you can actually calculate the mass concentration of a substance suspended in a solution if it has strong absorbance properties. For this purpose, the method of UV-Vis sample prep is very important. In part one, you watched me prepare a qualitative measurement using pipetters to measure the volumes of the silver colloid and the water that it's being diluted down with. If you were to try and use that data from that measurement to calculate mass concentration of your substance, you would only get approximate values. When you prepare the sample on an analytical balance, you increase the accuracy of the volume significantly. We use this practice very frequently when we prepare dilutions of nanomaterial and need to verify that the target concentration after the dilution was achieved. I'll explain that process in a bit more detail later. Now, to prepare what we call a quantitative sample, you first need an analytical or semi-analytical balance. These are balances that measure weights in the sub-milligram range. An ideal balance for this would be one that measures as low as 0.1 milligrams, because oftentimes the nanoparticle sample volume can be quite low in the 10 to 100 microliter range, which for most aqueous colloids translates to milligrams directly, since the density of the liquid is essentially the same as that of water, which is 1 gram per milliliter. Now, before preparing the sample dilution, you'll need to figure out what volumes are going to be needed in order to prepare a solution that has an absorbance or optical density of about 1, since that's the optimal OD for measuring on the spectrophotometer. It's quite straightforward if the absorbance is known. For example, all of our nanomaterials come with a certificate of analysis, which includes the optical properties such as peak wavelength and absorbance. So if the reported optical density of the material was 150, you'd need to prepare a 150-fold dilution. In this case, you need to measure out 100 microliters of the nanoparticle solution and bring it up to about 15 mils with water. If the absorbance of the colloidal solution is not known, a qualitative sample, which we covered in part one, will need to be prepared and measured in order to approximate the optical density. Then a subsequent quantitative sample can be prepared and measured based on those results.
So now that you're ready to prep your sample, you'll want to weigh out the nanoparticle solution in a vial or bottle large enough to accommodate the final dilution volume. And that's going to be pretty substantial because, as you can see, we're working here with concentrated, it's really dark, so this is concentrated silver BioPure, 20 nanometers, and as you can see, it's pretty dark. This has an OD or absorbance of about 166, so we're going to have to do a 166-fold dilution to measure on the UV-Vis spectrophotometer accurately. So we're going to start off by placing our scent vial inside the balance. Make sure you tear it. And I've pre-calculated my solutions because I already know the concentration of this particular material and the OD. If you didn't know, you would have to prep a qualitative sample like we did in part one in order to approximate the OD, and then you can subsequently prepare an analytical sample for the quantitative measurement. So for this, I'm going to need about 50 microliters of this BioPure solution, and I'm going to dilute it up to about 9.5 mils with water. And now I'm going to write that number down. And next, I'm going to add the necessary amount of water with this stripette here. Let that remain stable, and then we'll write down that number. And now you're pretty much ready to measure it on the UV-Vis spectrophotometer. Once again, you'll blank it, and then you'll use the solution directly for the measurement. And that concludes part two of our UV-Vis series. In part three, I'll explain how to analyze your data to calculate mass concentration and track stability of a material over time. I'll also show you examples of spectral data from other plasmonic materials, such as these, and I'll demonstrate how the optical properties change depending on their shape and size. Thanks for watching, and please feel free to leave comments below.